No faith. Hello, Jake, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, good. So, I mean, you've been around a few years now, so you've seen a few of these War on I-4 rivalries. What does a rivalry mean to you when you know you're getting ready to play South Florida?
Just the whole history of everything. I mean, I got the luxury of being on the 2017 team we won and last year. And so, you know, we've been on a little bit of a streak, but there's so much history to this rivalry. And even going back to when the 2000s, early 2000s, and they were kicking our butts. So it's just, we want to even up the series and kind of, you know, this one's for all the old players too. They might have lost to these guys. They want to see us win.
Jake, is there a favorite memory for you for this series that kind of stands out to you?
It's got to be about everybody's, right? The 2017 kickoff return. That's got to be, I think, on the top of everybody's list. Yeah, that was just a crazy moment. I remember being on the sideline going crazy, running up and down the sideline. It was almost surreal. You know, it was like, it would be really cool if he takes this back right now, and he did. So it was awesome.
Jake, with you being a senior this season, how much did you take pride in being a leader inside the locker room?
I think everybody took a lot of pride in it. It was a really tough year, I think, to lead, and it was a new year. It was a year that nobody else has had to lead in before. I think, like I said in my last interview on here, I reached out to Michael Colubiali for some help, and just I've never been in this situation before. Nobody else has really been in this situation before, and I had to hold guys accountable when they're 1,000 miles away from me during the offseason, and then even when we got here, you know, it's not just about being accountable when we're in the building, but when this time we got to be accountable outside of the building too and making sure that we stay safe and keep everybody healthy. So it was just a different year all around, and we had to lead in a lot of different ways, and I really enjoyed it, enjoyed the process, the struggles of it. Kind of made me a better leader in the long run.
Jake, what have you seen? I mean, no, USF's had a tough year, but what have you seen from those guys defensively, and what sort of challenge do they present for you?
I just think their tempo on defense is the way they fly around. And they're fast, they're physical, they're always going to do that. I think that's a staple of their defense, but especially this year, even more than normal, they're really fast, they play hard, and that's going to be a great challenge for us.
Jake, you know, there's one game left on the schedule, maybe there's a bowl game too, but as you sort of wind down here in your college career, when someone says, you know, tell me about your UCF football career, what are some of the moments that immediately come to mind?
I think the 2018 championship game, I scored my first collegiate touchdown against Memphis. So that was awesome to have that. I enjoyed the Fiesta Bowl on that trip. I enjoyed the Stanford game, and you know, hopefully I create some more memories next year. So,
Jake, I was actually going to ask that because the senior day was last Saturday and I noticed you did not walk. So have you made a decision? Everyone can have another year to come back if they want it. Is that a year that you want?
Yeah, I think I'm definitely going to take it. You know, getting another year under the system with Golesh, I think is going to be really beneficial for me. Also, we have a really young room. Gives me an opportunity to kind of leave a legacy with those guys, help them kind of figure out, you know, how to get things done and the process of being a college football player. So if I can stay and pass that along to those guys and get another year under Coach Golesh and grow, you know, that sounds good to me, so.
What went into that decision? Who did you talk with? How much of an impact did Coach Golesh have on that decision for you?
I got to talk to Golesh and my parents, you know, Coach Heupel a little bit. And I think everybody's conversation kind of went into my decision. You know, Golesh got the chance to, you know, sit down with me and say his plans for next year and this off season and, you know, what kind of work we're going to put in for my game, especially in the things that I need to work on. It was really exciting to hear that. And I don't think I'm ready to quite hang it up yet or move on. You know, if I can keep playing, I'm going to try to exhaust every outlet I can. So that's my plan for now.
Jake, there's been a lot of talk about obviously McKenzie, you know, maybe possibly coming back on Friday in Tampa. What would it mean to you guys to see him get back on the football field again?
It would be awesome just because of how hard he's worked even these past 2 years. We see it day in and day out. He's always the first one in the building and the last one to leave. He's always in the training room, always trying to get better. I think it would just be good for him, the fans, everybody, really. It'd be a good moment because, you know, that's where it happened 2 years ago. So I think it'd be really cool if we got to see him out there. But again, if the time is right and the situation is right in the game, who knows? But it's just the only reason that we're even having this conversation is just because of the way that he worked the past 2 years to put himself in this position. So
Jake, and what are your initial comments about Black Friday and USF? Have you seen it indicate, you know, you have some knowledge about the history of this series, and then you talked about evening up the series because USF obviously dominated early on. I know there was a game in 2007, they won 64-12. A lot of UCF fans kind of consider that the low point of the program in some respects. So kind of talk about that. Is that something as a team that you've talked about? Is evening up the series and doing stuff like that?
Well, Arm especially, we have two pretty much UCF historians in the Holler brothers. You know, they grew up in local area, big fans of the program. I know I'm pretty sure most of you guys saw Max on the Twitter on ESPN back in the 0-12 year. But so yeah, we got a little bit of the history from them. You know, we kind of have a little joke in the tight end room right now when we break it down. We're doing it for Max because his hatred runs deep. So they've given us a little history lesson, and you know, it's been nice.